Welcome back! This is the 7th video in the Digital Watercolor Painting Challenge. Today we are going to learn how to vary the appearance of the flower we painted in the previous tutorial using the Hue Saturation Brightness tool. Group the layers so we can easily move them all at once by just selecting the group. Use the Transform tool to place the pansy in one of the corners. Duplicate the group. The color is much more intense now, right? Duplicating layers is a fast way to get a more opaque result. Although this looks more like wash to me. Anyway, move the duplicated group aside. We are going to modify the illustration on the right, and we need the other one to be close to compare. Let's merge these two layers and go to Adjustments. Tap on Hue Saturation Brightness. As you see, we have two options, Layer and Pencil. Let's see how the first one works. Three sliders have appeared at the bottom of our screen. Let's start with the one in the middle, the saturation. Here we can control the vibrancy of the color. Now the flower on the right is more saturated than the other one. See? Look at how vibrant these colors are. With the brightness slider, we control the lightness or darkness of our illustrations. Set the brightness to the maximum and then to the minimum and see what happens. By the way, a fast way to make the colors of our illustration look paler is to desaturate it and increase its brightness a little bit. With the hue slider, we can change the color. If we have a few different colors in the same layer, I recommend making only small changes, because big changes don't usually look good. But if we have just one color or pretty similar colors in the same layer, the hue slider is really useful. Let's duplicate the group again and move it down. Be sure you have selected the watercolor layer, not the group. So far we can't modify the hue saturation brightness of a group of layers, okay? Tap on pencil this time. Now we are free to modify any area of our illustration. Let's decrease the brightness so you see this better. For example, imagine I only want to modify this part. I can change its color. I can make it look darker, like if it were on shadow, or if I want it to look lighter, I can do it too, see? We can change a small part, or the entire flower. I don't know, let's make the orange petals white. I am using the same brush, but we can use any brush we want, okay? We can also use the smudge and eraser tools. We need to add shadows, so let's tap on Apply. And now we can adjust the sliders to get a nice bluish color for our shadow areas. As you see, I am following the same steps I took in the previous video. I am using the smudge tool to blend colors. I am varying the brush size. So perhaps you are wondering why I didn't draw another flower. Well, two reasons. Because I wanted to show you how this tool works and because most of the work is already done. This is like using a stencil. I cannot paint outside the boundaries of the image, see? And using this tool, all the flowers keep the same level of transparency. In any case, there is more than one way to cook an egg. So if you prefer to do this using clipping mask or redrawing the flower, you can do it. Just teaching you everything you can do in Procreate. I think I will make the center yellow. Let's draw a stroke to see the changes better. Now I got yellow. Okay, I think you got the point and I don't want to bore you, so I will just play the time-lapse video to give you some more ideas on how you can transform your poppies using the Hue Saturation and Brightness tool. To make them look more different, you can also add more paint or water to the edges. Or even use the Liquify tool. We'll talk about the Liquify tool in another tutorial. Don't forget to share with me what you create on Instagram. I would love to see it. And if you have any questions, write a comment. I'll reply as soon as possible. See you in the next tutorial. Bye!